Hello my dear students, welcome again for the online classes. Today we will start with the same lesson of geography, our changing earth. In the last lecture, I have given you the introduction of the lesson, and today we will start with the first topic, that is lithospheric plates. Outermost layer of the earth crust is made up of separate but adjacent plates of the lithosphere. That is, there are different adjacent plates or the blocks out of which the earth crust is made up of. But we cannot see the cracks or we cannot see the blocks separately. But under the earth crust, there are different blocks of which the earth crust is made up of. Now these blocks move in relation to each other. Then they are constantly moving on the semi-molten rocks. Why? Because children, the second layer below the crust is the mantle, and in mantle we have the hot molten magma, and these lithospheric plates or blocks, they are floating in this layer, that is on the hot molten magma. See children, in the last lecture we have studied about the earth crust, and below the earth crust this is the mantle and this is the inner core. In mantle we have the hot molten magma which is continuously moving like this, and these plates, this is the earth surface, or we see it plain from the top, but there are different blocks of these lithospheric plates which are constantly moving in relation with each other in the hot molten magma. Now we know that the hot molten magma in this layer is, the hot molten magma is very hot, it has the high pressure. So the high pressure and the temperature in the mantle creates these forces, push the earth surface, and there are the changes which take place on the earth surface. Now children, as we know that these, as the lithospheric plates, they are the blocks, different blocks, so the gap, this hot molten magma, it sometimes, because of the inner pressure and the temperature and the force, it comes on the earth crust, and different changes took place on the earth crust in the form of rocks, in the form of different landforms. Movement of this lithospheric plate is divided into two types, vertical movement and horizontal movement. It is not mentioned in your textbook, but for the extra knowledge I am explaining of you about the movements of the tectonic plates. First one is the vertical movement. What does vertical movement causes? It causes the land to uplift or subside, or both, or both. So there is upliftment which causes the formation of new plateaus or plains or the rift valleys. Now how these landforms are created? Because of the vertical movement of the lithospheric plates. Then horizontal movement. The second one is the horizontal movement. Horizontal movement results in the formation of the mountains, trenches in the sea, and widening of the water bodies. Now because of this horizontal movement, it causes the folding and the faulting of the structure. I'll explain you about the folding and the faulting of the structure. What does the folding and the faulting means? But children, the thing which you have to understand is that the movements of the tectonic plates, how the changes took place on the earth's surface, and the movements are of the two types, vertical movement and horizontal movement, and these two movements are causing the various changes on the earth's surface. Now let us see what is folding and faulting. Now folding, it causes by the compression when the blocks of the land comes closer to each other and form the wrinkles or the folds on the earth surface. So this is the process of folding, because of which we see the wrinkles or the folds on the earth surface. Now the examples of the folding is the Andes of the South America, Alp mountains of the Europe, and the Himalayas of the India. These landforms are formed because of the folding structure. And the second one, faulting, the structure of the rocks crack or breaks along the weaker areas due to the tensions, and the structure of the rocks get displaced, and these movements have formed the block mountains. So why do we have the different types of mountains? Because of these structures. Thus, the examples are Vindhyas and the Satpura hills of India. These hills are created because of the faulting structure. So children, this is about the lithospheric plates, how our earth crust is made up of different but adjacent lithospheric plates or the blocks, and these blocks, these lithospheric plates, are continuously floating on the semi-molten rock, that is they are floating on the hot molten magma, and the changes which took place on the earth's surface because there is high pressure and temperature in this layer, that is the mantle. The changes which took place on the earth's surface because of forces, the pressure and the temperature inside the earth push these forces on the earth's surface, and we see the changes on the earth's surface.